I'm going to teach you guys how to jump off buildings today. My name is Corbin Reinhardt, and I'm a professional free runner. We're here at this playground of Tempest Freerunning Academy today. I want you guys to brace for impact. Let's go! Okay guys, so before doing this first part, you want to actually warm up your ankles. So the way that I usually warm up my ankles is I will start off by doing a couple jumps just like this. Or also, you could do the stanky leg just like this. You want to warm your ankles up by rolling them around and putting a little bit of energy into it without taking any real impact. So the first landing is to absorb to your legs. Now I would encourage you to do this on something smaller in the beginning of the day, but this is a video, so I have to do it hard, right at the beginning. When you land, you wanna have as much extension, and then as soon as you hit the ground, that's when you're gonna really start to absorb. When you absorb this, you wanna land on the balls of your feet. If anybody doesn't know, the ball of your foot is right here. No matter what movement you do in parkour, you're never landing on your heels. Don't land on your heels because it's going to shock you and you are going to feel it for the next year. Second thing is, you gotta pay attention to your knees. You do not want your knees to come 90 degrees to the side. You want them to come either forward or slightly angled. One thing I personally do is I like to have my hands come back just like this. What I want you guys to think of it as is like an owl when it goes for a mouse. They have their wings behind them and they have their talons in front of them. I want you guys to think of it in the same way. When I land, I want to use my arms to counterbalance so when I come back up, I can actually be in a neutral position. So, for recap, when you guys land, always land on the balls of your toes. Make sure your knees don't come out all the way outside. You either want them to go forward or diagonal. Personally, I like to have my arms behind me just like this to act as a counterbalance. And lastly, it's where your chest is at. You want your chest slightly forward so you can see where your toes are and you can keep your weight right above it. Here's a couple examples of absorbing to your legs. In parkour, we call them height drops. One thing I will say is I would not recommend you guys doing this like 10 times in a row. It's going to hurt your ankles, it's going to hurt your legs, but that is a good way of coming off of something like this height. If you guys are going off something a little bit higher than this, then I'm gonna show you the second landing technique. So as you can see, I jumped out a little bit on this one because it's a little bit higher. When I'm coming down onto this, I'm actually using my arms. I'm doing the same impact that I am for the first landing technique. Now, the only difference is I'm getting my chest a little bit further out, and when I land on my hands, I disperse into what's called a ground calm. I'm gonna take that impact and I'm gonna disperse it to my hands. As soon as I land on my hands, I'm gonna push through. With these last two landing techniques, I always run out. I want you to keep that energy flowing and you could actually recycle that momentum to go into something else. A couple examples of absorbing into a floor comp. So just to recap that, the first rule is that you have to warm up your wrists. The second rule is that you are still going to be taking the impact through the balls of your feet. Third rule is that you have to keep your chest a little bit further forward. Now you don't want to be all the way up here and you don't want to be all the way down here. You want to keep it a little bit further forward than the first landing technique. The fourth rule is that you are not using your hands to take the impact, but you are using them to disperse the momentum. And the last rule is that you are still going to run. Do not stop the energy, keep the energy going. You can see how tall this is compared to me. That's because we're gonna do our last landing technique. This is a jump to a roll. This is what you see in all the movies. The reason why we're doing this last is because this is probably the best landing technique for anything that's truly tall. So on this one, it's gonna be exactly the same as all the others in the beginning, but there is one really important piece to this. You do not wanna land with your feet too far apart. I wanna land with my feet right underneath me, almost underneath my shoulders. When I do this landing, I'm still on the balls of my feet, and I wanna have my chest a little bit further forward. You don't wanna be too far forward. You don't wanna be like a 45 degree angle. You wanna be looking like Michael Jackson in Smooth Criminal, okay? For me personally, I like to roll over my left shoulder. So when I put my hands down, I actually wanna put my hands in front of my right foot. So I'm gonna put my hands here. You need to keep your legs engaged and a little bit stiff so that when you get to this position on your forearm, you can push your hips up and over. You never wanna hit your bones. You only wanna hit your muscles. You wanna go over to either the side or over towards the back, right where my muscle is. That's where you want to take the impact in your roll. I never want to hit my spine, but we're going to try to minimize this as much as possible. So you have to roll diagonally across it, and you want to land right at the bottom, right here on your butt cheek. Onto your butt cheek, that leg should be looking like a triangle. And when you come up off the ground, to stand up, you want to rest your calf on the ground and use your leg and arms to push up and get back into a running formation. The last step, I want you to keep the momentum flowing and I want you to get back up and go. Make sure you pay close attention to this because here are the slow-mos of that movement. This is the basis of one of the most important movements in parkour, and you will use this for many different things. Here are a couple examples. I'm a little bit scared of this one. I don't think I've ever done it before, so we'll see about it. Hey guys, if you are enjoying this video and you want to be part of the Heart Club, I have a couple of shirts that are coming out very, very soon, and I'm going to have a link out there, so please keep an eye out for it. Yes, I know I did the last one to a mat. My feet hurt from all the ones that I did before, but I hope you guys got something from this video that might help you learn with parkour. Well, if you guys enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. Also, comment down what the next tutorial should be. Subscribe, as always, and hit that notification bell. Thank you guys so much for watching. Later, skaters!